Welcome everybody, in this video we will show you from start to finish how to prepare, scan and visualize the slides with Emotic EasyScan Infinity. Okay, so the first step would be to load the slides into the tray. So I've got a pack of different slides here and I will show you how to load them. So the first step for doing this would be to insert the slide just like this with an angle. And now you can press down. At the same time, you push the spring outside and now lock it in place. Now, rinse and repeat for all the slides. It doesn't take a lot of time. As you can see, it's an easy motion once you get it going. And I will leave two blank slides purposely to show you what happens with the software. Okay, so once you're ready to start the scanning process, you just need to put the slide into the right side of the scanner. Just like this. And now you can go to the computer and start with the scanning. We have already scanned the slides. I will show you in a moment. But first, before that, I want you to see a different feature. And that is the preview. This takes a little while. Once the preview has been loaded, you can see that some slides have a green outline and some others don't. What this means is that in the slides with a green outline, the program has automatically detected an area very defined and it has decided to automatically scan only what's inside the green area. On the red ones, it has detected that there's not enough definition to select an entire exact limit, so the entire red square will be selected. In some cases though, you might want to edit this, and it is possible to do by double clicking on the slide and changing the selection to another thing that you might consider. It's important to add that this step of previewing is optional. If you just want to do a batch scan of multiple slides, you just can press scan right away and forget about editing all of this. But if you want to change the settings individually, you can do the preview and once you are finished, just press scan. And this is how the scanning process begins. As you can see, while it is scanning, you can see the time used and the time left. I would also like to add that if you include a barcode, either a 1D or maybe a 2D barcode, like in this case, the name will change with the barcode, but this can be changed in the settings to whatever you like. A very good feature is that you're allowed to load multiple slides while it is scanning, so it would be on the go. Just lower them like this, just like before, and you can even close the lid. And that would be it. Okay, so while this is scanning, I will return to the slides that were scanned first. And which are the slides that we loaded. As you can see, the text appears on yellow, and this is because there is important information to be reviewed in this tray. And the thing is that the last two slides were left empty, of course, purposely, but the scanner doesn't know this, so that's the reason that they appear in yellow. It's to inform you that there is something different about the slides and that you need to review it. But the slides 1 to 4, which are the slides that we actually filled, are properly scanned. You can see them here. Okay, so once you have finished scanning, or you maybe just want to open the slides that have been scanned, just go to Emotic Digital Slide Assistant, select the folder where the slides are, and double click on any one that you want to open. In this case, I will open the last one that has been scanned. Let it load. And this is the final result. As you can see, the image quality is great.